Hey guys, Andrew here, also known as Slayer Rocker 86, and welcome to Minecraft 1.4 Snapshot Pre-Release 12w34a. So, this is the weekly roundup, snapshot roundup, whatever you want to call it. Now, if you guys haven't seen all the individual videos, shut up dogs! If you guys haven't seen all the individual videos showing off everything in here, you can hit the annotation on the left, and that basically shows everything individually. This video is going to be a big cluster duck of everything, so let me go ahead and get started. So, one of the things I will not be showing you in this video, which is only two things I won't be showing you in this video, because it takes time and isn't really necessary, is one, I would have to, for one, it didn't come out in the snapshot, but it's a secret thing, it is the wither. Now the wither, if you could actually hit the annotation on the bottom left, that'll take you to my channel where you guys could see the video of the wither, or you could scroll through the videos, go down a bit. And Kip actually showed that off. I couldn't get it working on my computer because it requires you to do a weird process of changing your .jar file, and it doesn't really work properly on Mac. So what I did is, well, what he did is he posted the video and I haven't actually been on it yet, but it's going to be in the next snapshot. I'm going to show off everything that's in the snapshot. The other thing that's in the snapshot that I'm not showing you in this video, if you make a portal, you could actually have animals or mobs or anything really can go through it. And they can also go into the ender portal, they just won't be able to come back. Now mobs from the nether can also come back from the nether world to this world and from this world to the nether world. So yeah. So, thing number one that I actually didn't show off, let me go into this chest and get me some dyes. Let me get one purple and let me get just some blue. You can now dye your puppy's colors. So that one's red. Dye it. Oh, it's blue. Now, no one really, like, we know, we told you guys that they were going to add this, like, dyeable colors. We thought, or collars. We thought that it was going to be kind of like a naming thing, so you could, like, name your doggies. But in a way, you kind of can. You can have it so that the purple one is, like, Chuck, the blue one is Billy. So, symbolism, I guess, could stand for that. And, yeah, so that's kind of cool, and not that many people even know about it. So, let's go ahead and put this back. Let's show off some of the other cool things. Now, we're going to do a quick run-by. So, they added pots, flower pots, to be exact. I'll show that off in a second. They added these new cobblestone and mossy cobblestone walls. You could also put your wooden stairs in, like, angles. I'll show that off in a second. They added item frames. They made it so that trapdoors can now be placed in more places, which is really good. I'll show that off in a second. Clocks can actually be put in frames as well as everything else, and you'll see one really cool thing about that. Also, they added carrots, potatoes, and golden carrots, which I'll show you how to make that in a second. They also added the poisonous potato and the empty maps, which you could also clone them, which I'll show you how to do that as well. They added this new wooden button, and this one is actually a button that's different from the stone one, because if you put it on a wall, you could hit it with an arrow and it'll trigger. Why is that good? For adventure maps, you can now have it, or for anything really, that you could have a little adventure thing to it. Like, you have to shoot your bow, triggers a redstone thing, and it opens a door. I don't know, I think that's cool. And they've also added the splash potion of invisibility, which I'll end this video with. And of course, we got the baked potato. And of course, to the right over here, we've got a regular leather wood, or not wood, regular leather armor. And actually, this will be the first thing I'm going to show off. Let me add this all into my inventory. And let me add one of each of the dyes. So let's take one of that, one of that, one of blue. Actually, I don't like that blue. Let's take this blue over here. And let's take green. Okay. So what you do to dye your, oop, my bad. What you do to dye your armor is, this only works for leather, by the way. You, let's see, what should we have for the bottom? You put your leather armor over here, and then you get the dye. You put it in your crafting table. Doesn't matter what order. It could be like this, or like that, anything. And there you go. So, shift click on that, and then you get your leather pants. Let's make the leather pants blue. Let's make the helmet orange, kind of like a crown type of thing. And let's make your chest piece green. I think that'll look pretty cool. Now, I am on creative, so I'm just going to go into this little survival thing, and I'll drag it on in there, and you guys will be able to see my new colorful armor. And this actually looks pretty awesome. And I'll go ahead and go into fifth person, or not fifth person, F5, which is third person. And one of the cool little glitches is that your sword changes colors. Now, this is only for the snapshot pre-release. It will be fixed. But look at this. I mean, this is clothing now. This is amazing. And I mean, this is just so creative, the different combinations you could have. Of course, now you could have like Team Defender, I guess, red versus blue type of games. And that's just awesome. Just the fact that people are gonna be running around in their own custom clothes. And now clothing shops are gonna like emerge in Minecraft communities. I think that's gonna be pretty sweet. So let's continue on and show you some of the crops. Now, let's get ourselves some carrots. Let's get ourselves some potatoes. And now, you can farm them. I'm going to go ahead and get myself a diamond hoe. And I don't really need anything else. I'll go ahead and get bone meal as well. I could use a bucket of water, but nah, we don't need it right now. So, let's break some dirt over here. And it's not really going to go very well because I don't really have any water. But, who cares? So, we'll put the carrots to the right. We'll put the potatoes to the left. We'll use some magical bone meal to insta-grow it. And there you go. I'm going to give you guys a good view of this so you can see. And because there's no water, let me go ahead and get a bucket of water that's going to help them stay alive. Because it's kind of in a biome that's not very suited for this. So, what you're going to want to do in a biome like this, put the water down. And you're going to want to get yourself a torch or some sort of light. And that's going to keep ice from melting. Or not ice from melting, but ice from forming near it. And there we go. So I'm just putting a ton of torches all around here that will keep the ice away and snow away. So we can hold this back down, put a carrot, or actually that was a potato. Put a carrot, and let me actually switch game modes. To switch game modes, you do slash game mode, your name. So Slayer Rocker 86, actually no, slash game mode 0. That puts me in survival. Now, I'm going to use bone meal to speed up the process. And yeah, so that's how you guys can see. Those are how carrots look. They look pretty cool. And that's how potatoes look. And the really sweet thing about this is, keep in mind, right now I have 32 potatoes. When you break this, you get sometimes some more. That one only dropped in once. But to put them back down, you just right-click again. They don't require seeds. So that's a pretty sweet thing. And yeah, and then of course you can have them grow again. And the same thing goes for carrots. You just break them. And several more come out, you only need one to be placed down. Break them, several come out, you only need one to be placed down. And yeah, and then you can just keep on the growth, or you can keep doing the growth process. So let me get my diamond ingot over here so I can show you how to make yourself a diamond carrot. So it requires one carrot. And actually, let me first get my golden ingot. You're gonna get your golden ingot, you're gonna put it in the crafting table, and you're gonna get 9 golden nuggets. Now you only need 8 of these. You're gonna put them all around the crafting table, just like that. Put your carrot in the middle, and bam, you get a golden carrot. And with this magical golden carrot that I have right over here, I don't believe you could eat it. You might, but you actually use this for the invisibility potion, which I will show that in the end of this video, because I really don't want to become invisible for the whole video. So that was it for that. And of course, to get a baked potato, you just get a furnace and you put your potato in there and it'll be baked. And yeah, as for the poisonous potato, I don't know exactly, and we will make a video about that in the future. Now let's show off maps. Maps is gonna be pretty cool. Let me get rid of all this stuff in my inventory. So maps are now plain. What you're gonna want to do is, when you have one in your hand, you're gonna right click it, and as you guys can see right over here, it formed a brand new one. And the whole entire thing generates the whole entire land. You don't have to start walking around, it will just generate the whole thing. And that is awesome. And as you guys can see, it stays stable, which is pretty awesome. And I believe you could also zoom in when you go in the crafting table if you put paper all around it. And I want to thank my fans for helping me with that, because they were the ones that told me. Now this is another thing, if you put a map in there, and you could actually clone maps now. Put a regular empty, or not empty, but no, yeah, empty map in there. It will make 2 of the same maps. So that way you can clone them, give them to your friend, whatever. And yeah, now let's show off another really sweet thing. Let me go back into that. Let's get some, let's get the frames. I want to show off the frames. And I'm also going to need these walls, because I want to show off the walls as well. So I'll show them both off at the same time. Okay, like I said in the snapshot videos of this week, or the snapshot news videos, which, by the way, number one source for Minecraft snapshots. Oh, crap. Let me go into game mode 1. There we go. And actually, let me go into blocks. You will be able to see that they are right over here. So put them back down. And let's build a wall. So these walls are kind of what... Here, let me build a nice little thing. They are basically fences. Now you can't jump over them. Of course I have to fly over them, because they have the same prospect, or whatever you want to call it, that fences do. So that's pretty sweet. And of course you could stack them like so, like I told you guys that it would look, and it looks awesome. So it's just like a fence in a way. And yeah, let me actually turn my render distance down. I know I don't need to be on far, that just causes lag. But yeah, looking at that, that's pretty sweet. Same thing goes for mossy stone. And yeah, now the reason why I wanted to put this down is so that I could have a frame for... Oh, actually, I just realized. That looks really sweet. Look at that. Just the new possibilities. And the really cool thing about this is now you guys can... Now, they haven't come out with stone yet. It's only cobblestone. But for people that have skyscrapers, you can now have a very tall needle. And I think that's just going to look really cool. Also for any other kind of designs. So, we got that. Let's put the frames down. I don't want to kill my dogs, but they're being really loud. I'm just going to go ahead and turn the Minecraft sound down. And let's put the frames over here. Frame. Now, one of the sweet things about frames is right-click an item in, and there you go. You got an active map, and it actually shows a live feed of people in there. So, let's say you have an outpost in your town or something. You can have the maps all hanging there, and people will be able to see the land and people that are there. And then we go in here, put the map back out, and get the clock. This is something I have been waiting for the longest time. Right-click, and bam, you have an active wall clock. It is an active wall clock, literally. Now watch this. I'm going to go ahead and change the time to daytime and look at the clock. Look as it changes time. Look how cool that is. And let's do it again, except this time let's make it nighttime and watch it rotate. Look at that. Isn't that just the coolest thing ever? So yeah, we have active clocks now. You could put one of these downstairs underneath, I don't know, in a cave system. Put it like in the little underground outpost where you guys have all your chests so you can always keep track of what time it is. And yeah, just another pretty cool thing. And of course, you could always put a sword. And of course, one thing I didn't show you guys, if you right click, you can rotate everything that's inside. So the clock, you can rotate it for the fun of it, just to confuse people. And swords could actually be like arrows in a way. So, you know, for directions, where should I go? To the top, like in the mall or something. Top means, or I don't know, you could have like a sign that says main floor, or I don't know, the main district building, and it could be pointing to the top or the bottom right or the bottom left or the top left. So I don't know, I thought that was pretty awesome in my opinion. And yeah, let's look at what else is in the snapshot. So I ran by a lot of things. Let's go to flower pots, and let me get rid of my current inventory so I don't have that in here and I get confused. So flower pots will basically hold any type of tree, life, sapling type of thing. So let's put some of these guys down right over here, and they don't look that incredible. They look decent, I guess. It's just really like a little mug, and the plants in it don't really grow. They're just there to look cool. And yeah, so, there you guys can get a good view of it. I actually should take a screenshot of this. This is a really good screenshot. So, wait for it. This is gonna be the thumbnail right here, guys. Or guys. Ready? 3, 2, 1, say hi! Or cheese. There we go. And snapshot taken. And you guys can tell because it's a snapshot taken right over there. Woohoo! Okay, so we got ourselves a really good thumbnail. What else should we show off? The crops. The crops are all looking great. Let's look. We showed dyeing this and everything. What else did we miss? We have, I gotta show you guys the trap lores. I also want to show you guys, but we're saving that for the end, the invisible effect. I'm trying to think. I heard you could put paintings. Let me go ahead and get a painting out here. Let me get rid of this inventory stuff. And let me get myself a frame. So, let me break this frame and put this one up here. I don't know. Aww, I thought you would get like a really cool painting. Okay, one other really cool thing. I don't know the, what's it called? I don't know the block type for fire, but you could kind of put, you could put fire in here and it shows, not in an active 3D thing, but it shows fire and that looks pretty cool. Actually, it might show an active 3D thing. We'll find out in a later video. I'll make a video about that, I promise. So, what else could we show? Let's put a 3D block in there, actually. I want to see how that looks. See if it's really 3D-like or not. Ready? Oh, that was actually not even a frame at all. Okay, put that in there. Let's put a 3D flame or block. And yeah, it is a block. Wow. Like, that is legitimately a block, looking at it. That's pretty sweet. So you actually put like a mini version of a block down. For the clock is a flat thing, just like the map is. But yeah, blocks are like 3D, and then you can right-click them, and I guess you could do whatever you want. Your creativity is your limits, or imagination is your limits, whatever you want to call it. So let's look at trapdoors. You could basically put them apparently... Oh, thank you, Jeb. You can put them anywhere now. So let me break this so you guys can get a better idea of this. So yeah, you could put them on these edges up here now. So they're actually like trapdoors. Wow, before it was kind of like laying above them, which was extremely annoying. It was just like this pretty much. So yeah, if you guys could see the difference of how it is now, that's how it used to be. It would always have to be like that. So yeah, it's a lot better now that you could actually have them within So they're actually traps, and they go down. They go down. Oh my god, that would have been so useful. That would have been so useful in like the in Minecraft Jackass. But yeah, so now we actually have trap doors, so you could like I guess go through tripwire and then fall flat down. But yeah, that's awesome. And not a lot of people actually caught that. So let me think. What else is in the snapshot? Looking at everything else, I think I've got almost everything. I'm gonna go ahead and get my potion of invisibility. I also want to let you guys know some of the things I did talk about in the news video are not out just yet. And those things are hats. Hats have not been added yet, and they were tweeted by Dearbone. So they might be coming out in the next snapshot. We don't know exactly when. Other thing, Dyeable glass. That hasn't been added yet. It might come out in the next snapshot. And Dyeable beds haven't come out yet, as far as we know. We've tried everything with them, either making them with the different type of wool and everything. It hasn't worked. I'll go ahead and try again for you guys. This is another thing. Now, we did use colored wool. That didn't work. So this is another thought that I had while I was thinking about it. So let's try it this way. Let's see, dye, we'll use pink dye, I guess. Put the wood in the bottom, put this on top. Oh, I just realized they don't have enough dye. Okay, but I don't think the dye is gonna work at all. So I'll go ahead and get more dye. So got the dye, let's make it green. Green would be cool. But yeah, we can't figure it out. We believe that dyeable beds have not been added for this snapshot specifically. So that's kind of a bummer, but in the next one they will be. So we know that for a fact. Dinnerbone tweeted it, and they were really working really hard on the snapshot. They had the wither, and you guys have seen the video from us. We have it if you haven't seen it. That's a huge mob with three heads as a serpent body, and that one wasn't officially added to the snapshot. You kind of have to use a hack client type of thing, not a hack client, but a modded file to have it in, because it crashes like crazy. It literally crashed the crap out of my Minecraft. Try not to do it, guys, because it really messed me up for 2 hours. That's why this video was actually delayed. But yeah, they added that, and Kid will be making another video of that. And yeah, so they did do a lot of stuff with Minecraft, and I missed one of the most important things. I just realized that. Where is it? Oh my gosh. Rotatable. There we go. Rotatable, or not rotatable, corner. I don't know what to call them. Corner stairs. There we go. Corner stairs have been added, and wabang, there you go. And I think that's just awesome. So, look at that. It's like a trapdoor right underneath. That's so sweet. But yeah, now you guys can have like a little hot tub and everything. And the figures for this and everything is just incredible. Just looking at it, it's amazing. So, yeah, wanted to show that off for you guys. Just the different things you could do with stairs now. Or, yeah, stairs now is unlimited. So, yeah, that's basically everything in the snapshot, guys. I don't know what else I missed besides portals, mobs going through them, and the wither. Which, by the way, we did make videos of that, but it's not in here. Besides that, we pretty much covered everything. Just checking all this stuff. I think that is every single thing. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. And before I go, I will go ahead and make myself disappear. Let me take off my armor completely. So hold shift and remove that. And drink some of this. And I am invisible. And let's actually spit this out. So now you guys can't see me. That's actually pretty sweet. You can't see me. Hello, viewers. Oh, but you can still see bubbles. So this is actually, we thought that the bubbles would give it totally away, but it doesn't. So just imagine this. It's going to be incredible. But yeah, guys, I'm SlayerRock86. You really can't see me. Let me take my sword out. Oh, what am I looking at? Wait. Okay, there we go. Okay. I'm SlayerRock86, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see everything again in like private videos or like in a single video, hit the annotation in the bottom left of the screen, that'll take you to it. That is so cool, it's just a floating sword. Oh, that's really sweet. But yeah guys, that's pretty much it, I showed everything off. I hope you enjoyed this. Remember, we make new videos, or not just new videos, but news videos almost every single day. As soon as like Dinnerbone or Jeb tweet anything out, we'll make a video about it informing you guys. So you guys will be up to date on everything that's coming out for all of the snapshots. And what the heck? There's a random block over there.
I just realized something! Your doggies can become invisible with you, boy!
Your doggies can become invisible with you. OMG. Let's make you invisible.
Your dogs can become invisible too!
Oh, that is just awesome! Thank you, subscribers. I remember one of you guys said that. So yeah, your dogs can also become invisible, and it's just their collar. You have invisible dogs. That is amazing. Okay, guys, I'm SlayerRock86. That was Invisible Dogs. This was officially everything in Minecraft. Snapshot 12w34a. And yeah, I'm SlayerRock86. give this video a like. Come on, give it a like. Subscribe, new videos every single day. Keep up to news of Minecraft. Just keep checking out the channel every single day. And yeah, SlayRock86, leave a comment below on what you think. And I will talk to you guys later. Make sure to join our server. The website is frzworld.com. And yeah, homepage is where we have all the IPs on the top banner. And that's pretty much it. I will talk to y'all later. Make sure to subscribe. And yeah, bye.